Hello everyone. Thank you for coming to this seminar. It's my pleasure to invite the Professor Osamu Takyu from Shinshu University in Japan. And I also introduce Fukuda-kun and Ikeuchi-kun. They are master course student of Professor Takyu. And I would like to introduce Professor Takyu. Professor Osamu Takyu received the PhD degrees at Keio University in Japan in 2006. And he is now an associate professor in the Department of Electrical and Electronic Engineering, Shinshu University, Japan. The title of presentation is Wireless Sensor Networks for Real-Time Wireless Communication and Spectral Sharing. Please start your presentation. Thank you.
Okay, so thank you. Thanks, Professor Kameda, introduce me and having the opportunity to show my research. Before starting this research topic, so I would like to introduce me and our university. I'm Osamu Takyu, it's Shinshu University, is associate professor from 2030. My current research interest in resource allocation for wireless communications, wireless access for cognitive radio, and baseband processing for wireless communications. I think actually the Shinshu University is not so familiar. Shinshu University is in the Nagano Prefecture in Japan. So let me explain where the Nagano is. This is a Japanese map. It's here, and Nagano is here. But we can see that Nagano is the geographical center of Japan. So, but of course, I think Tokyo is much more famous. Tokyo is actually the economical center of Japan. So, slightly is far from the Tokyo. Nagano is slightly far from the Tokyo. It takes about half an hour by bullet train. But anyway, so in Nagano is around there are a lot of mountains, so therefore Nagano is mountain regions. Let me show the side view from our campus. This is a north view and this is a south view. As we can see, there are a lot of mountains and there are a lot of mountains. 360 degrees, there are those mountains around Nagano. So in Nagano, it's a quite high altitude area. It is quite cold. And the Nagano is quite similar weather to the New Jersey. Let me show the monthly temperatures like this. It's the left hand side, Nagano, right hand side, New Jersey. Please pay attention to the winter seasons. And winter seasons in minimum temperature is under the 0 degree. It's quite cold. And also the New Jersey is as well. And this pink color one indicates how many snow it is. So actually in Nagano, it's a lot of snows as well. So therefore, Nagano is a mountainous area. We can enjoy winter sports, especially the skiing is very famous. So therefore, winter season's competition of Olympic was held in 1998. It's quite old, not so old. And this is the opening ceremony. And in Nagano City, there are some places for enjoying the winter season sports. Like this is one, it's a speed skating place. It's quite famous. Anyway, so let me introduce my universities at Shinshu University. Shinshu University is composed of 7 faculties and 1 school as well. And about 10,000 students study in our universities. And this is my faculties of engineering. There are 5 departments of department in my university. My department is electrical and computer engineering. And in, let me introduce the institution of mountain science. Because, as I said, Nagano is a mountainous area. Mountain science is really active. For example, the prevent disaster and reduce it is really active. But unfortunately, I'm not related to this research, so I cannot explain the details. So please move to the next one. Okay. So let's start my research topic. Okay. I'm interested in Internet of Things. IoT is expected for important business model gathering the huge profit, such as home energy management system, the monitoring for buildings and planets, and agriculture, nature environment monitoring, and medical care like this. So, a lot of people pay attention to the IoT. The wireless sensor networks is an important infrastructure for supporting the IoT because wireless sensor network delivers the sensing information to internet or server. As I explained, there are a lot of applications of IoT requirement. Therefore, requirement of wireless sensor net is highly diversified. If we consider the application, for example, the real-time applications such as robotics, automatic driving system, low latency must be required. And accommodation of massive sensors for large-scale monitoring should be required if we consider the seismic intensity meter and the huge earthquake or explosive or volcano is happened. I'd like to explain later in detail. And third one is the high strictness of automatic collection services for supporting the bill collecting system of parking. So anyway, so, let me show the standard of wireless sensor network. These four standards are popular in Japan. These four standards categorized into two. First one is a 2.4 GHz band, is ISM band. And the two band is 920 MHz, is a sub GHz band. The difference between two categories is a coverage. In the ISM band, the support is over around 100 meters like this, but the sub GHz band is over the 1 kilometer, coverage is over the 1 kilometer. And the frequency bandwidth is quite larger, is a 2 MHz band, and about the sub GHz case is quite narrow. But there are four standards commonly used there. Packet access scheme for wireless access. But I think packet access scheme cannot every time satisfy the requirement of IoT. So let me explain the reason of it. The packet access, packet including the payload of digital sensing data and the header information is constructed, and then each sensor sends a constructed packet to fusion sensor individually. Let me show the example. There are five sensors. If each sensor sends a packet to the fusion center. Fusion center means a data center. So it sends like this and like this, like this. This is an image of in time domain. The image of packet arrival in time domain. As we can see, each packet is arrival time division manner. So therefore, a sharp 5 packet is quite a delay with arrival with large delay. So, but the advantage of packet access is a high strictness of wireless communications. This is a very good advantage. But some disadvantages is, as I explained, the accessing time delays occurs for avoiding the packet collisions. In this situation, it's a really ideal case. As you know, the wireless sensor network is distributed network. So therefore, timing synchronized. The each sensor does not have the ideal timing synchronization. So therefore, for avoiding the packet collisions, random backoff is required. Random backoff is a random timing delay. So therefore, in this in distributed sensor network, additional delay is occur. And the other disadvantage is the instantaneous access from massive sensor is not affordable. And third one is the statistical analysis is required after collecting the sensor from the, all the data. Recently, the conventional works for constructing the real-time wireless sensor networks have been considered. First one is the spread spectrum technique. It is the frequency hopping scheme is achieved the mitigating the packet collision. And does not avoid it, but perfectly does not avoid it. But one of the problem is the assignment protocol or hopping pattern for avoid the duplication and assignment is required. And also the non-orthogonal multiple access NOMA is also a powerful technique. But NOMA is required a lot of computational complexity process and multiple antenna. So therefore, we consider the simply and low latency wireless access scheme could be required for IoT. So therefore, let me introduce the physical wireless parameter conversion sensor network, where it is referred to as a PHYSI-SN, short name. In the PHYSI-SN, sensor node selects a subcarrier in accordance with the mapping table between the sensing result and subcarrier, and then send it to FU center. Let me show the example. There are five temperature sensors like this. So each sensor selects one subcarrier. For example, 50 degrees is a sharp edge subcarrier, and 12 degrees is a sharp 5, and something like that. These relationships between the temperature and subcarriers has been decided by mapping table. Mapping table, fusion center and all the sensors share the mapping table. And after that, all the sensors send the subcarriers simultaneously to FC, is like this. As we can see, each subcarrier has a different frequency. This frequency is decided to the temperature degrees. So therefore, it's obviously that all the data interfered. But in FC, can detect the frequency spectrum by a fast Fourier transform, is like this. So each subcarrier has a spike frequency spectrum. So therefore, FC can recognize distribution of spectrum. So therefore, in accordance to the mapping table, FC can obtain each sensing data like this. For your imaging the our considered PHYSI-SN technique, let me show the movie. It's two movies. First one is a motion capture case. It's based on six-axis sensor. It's applied to PHYSI-SN. Second one is a multiple motion capture case. This is a motion capture. It's quite a moving. This is a real-time spectrum analyzer. It's a vertical axis spectrum and the horizontal axis intensity of signal power. This is a history of detective spectrum. As you can see, the motion capture is moving. The spectrum is moving. It's here. So please let's see the history of spectrum detectors. This is indicating the motion position. It's like this. Let me show the multiple case. And this is also the real-time spectrum analyzer each sharp signal is a subcarrier indicator, a subcarrier component, and quite sure image. And this is a motion capture. There are totally is a 10 motion capture is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and the other one is also 5. Okay, this is a detected as frequency spectrum like this. Okay, the advantage of 5CSN is median and outlier of all the sensing results can be recognized by one FFT process and demapping. Give me the example. This here. So, in this case, median is here and outlier is here or here. Can be recognized one time. And so, therefore, real time data collection is available and stochastic data for all the sensing result is recognized by one time. And low power and wide. I escaped it. Okay, so if we consider this advantage, so let me show the considered applications. First one is the earthquake of explosion of volcanoes. There are a seismic sensor in the volcanoes areas. If explosion is happen, all the sensors sense the seismic intensity. So if we use 5CSN, the seismic intensity is we can recognize distribution of sensing. We can recognize the distribution of seismic intensities from all the sensing results. So therefore, some outlier can be recognized. And the other one is a position of robotics or vehicle. If we use the motion sensor is under the vehicle, so it so also the moving the vehicles the. If this vehicle is balancing, so each motion sensor is uniformly distributed. But the unbalancing case is some part motions is some spectrum are how to say so converge to in some motions. So therefore, in the fusion center can recognize balance or unbalance. So therefore, we can obtain advantage from the 5CSN, but as well the disadvantage of 5CSN is there are two disadvantages of 5CSN. First one is the information source of each sensing result is unspecified. Information source is a sensor node. Because each sensor does not inform FC of sensor node ID, just simply the sinusoidal wave. And the other one is a larger frequency bandwidth is required for supporting large dynamic range and high resolution of sensing results. Therefore, I think spectrum sharing among the other wireless system and ICSN is mandatory. For recovering these advantages, we consider two projects. First one is a carrier frequency offset for sensor node is identification in 5CSN. Second one is adaptive channel assignment for frequency sharing among wireless systems. In this time, let me show that this two second part. Okay, so let's move to the adaptive channel assignment for frequency sharing among wireless systems. So the other advantage of 5CSN is low power and wide range communications. Because each sensor uses monotone signal with low PAPR and high signal power density. So powerful wireless sensor network powerful wire sensor network with sharing frequency spectrum is also a wide range of communications. I consider. Let me show again the standard of wire sensor network. If we pay attention to sub-gigahertz band, sub-gigahertz standard, frequency bandwidth is quite so narrow, and the coverage is quite larger. So therefore, it looks like similar to the PhiCSN. So therefore, we pay attention to spectrum sharing between the sub-gigahertz band and the PhiCSN. And in addition, this two coverage is really commonly, I mean, the how can I say, it's common data. But actually, it's in each case is different. So in our work, we pay attention to the relationship between antenna height and the coverage. So we perform the experimental evaluations in sub-gigahertz band. We use LPWAs as the LoRa one. It's like this. This is a gateway. Gateway is a fusion center, data centers. And the other one is a spectrum sensor. This is a transmitter, is a sensor with a GPS sensor. The sensor has the GPS sensor. Each sensor informs the location and intensity of received signal to LoRa gateway. So therefore, we can perform logging of LPWA. So let me show the experimental results. First one is a still environment. The LoRaWAN gateway is located on the top of buildings. It's like this. So a LoRa gateway is about 20 meters higher than sensor node. So this is the evaluation result. Yellow indicator means the successfully received the signal from the sensor to gateway. But this is a gateway. From this result, the maximum distance for constructing communication between LoRa gateway and the sensor is 1.28 kilometer. This is one of the examples. This is my evaluations. 1.28 kilometers. And the second one is a hilly environment. LoRa gateway is located 130 meter higher than sensor node. LoRa gateway is located on the top of the hill. It's like this. So LoRa gateway is about 130 meter higher than sensor node. From this figure, almost maximum distance is about 7.41 kilometer. So therefore, six times higher antenna can support the six times larger coverage. So therefore, we consider a heterogeneous wireless environment among the wireless sub-gigahertz band wireless sensor networks. For example, if we use the higher antenna of gateways for supporting the large coverage, for supporting the large coverage area. But gateways supporting the small area, so maybe the antenna of gateway is located not so high. This is small, is a more sorry, the lower is like this, and the other one is a lower antenna case is support as covered the in some antenna. Okay, so cover area of middle high antenna and low antenna are overlap to that of high antenna. It's like this. So therefore, heterogeneous wireless communication is constructed. It looks like the cellular system between the small antenna and small cellular system overlap to the microcell systems. So in this environment, available channel are different for each location for a higher antenna system, because channels are occupied by different systems in each locations. So, but in the access from sensor to fusion centers, is a harmful interference is occur. And for example, if the sensor is located here to access to the higher antenna is like this, but it's easy to understand the harmful interference to the high middle-high antenna. So therefore, for we have to consider the protect to the harmful interference. So therefore, let me introduce the carrier sense multiple access technique. I mean the access scheme with carrier sensing technique in 4.5CSM. Okay, so let me explain how to use the access scheme with carrier sensing by secondary system and primary system model. And the primary system is the other system, and the secondary system is 5CSM, which I'm interested in. And if SHARP1 is sent subcarrier is like this, but this sensorial wave is a harmful interference to the primary system. But if this sensor detect is accessed by spectrum sensing, this sensor stops access, so therefore avoiding the harmful interference. And this is one of the avoiding to the harmful interference. But in this situation, we have to consider some problem. It is sensing result loss. If there is no primary system access, all the data is obtained like this. System is accessed to the channels. Some data is missing because this sensor stops the access. Sensing result. For example, in this case, is that 2 and 5 is missing because two sensors stop access for avoiding the collision. So therefore, we have to consider the compensation of sensing result loss and avoidance of harmful interference. So therefore, we propose channel assignment technique for 5G SNN. Firstly, let me consider the mapping table in 5G SNN. As I explaining, the each sensing level 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is like the temperature case 1 degree, 2 degrees, something like that. And assigned to the channel number is like this. And this is one of the example of mapping table. And each sensor send carrier signal to fusion center through the channel in accordance with the mapping table. So therefore, we have construct freedom of which channel to be used for sending sensing results. So therefore, we propose channel assignment based on mapping table. Firstly, is we consider two predictions. First one is a sensing result, and second one is a channel occupancy ratio. And after that, the cost based on two predictions is calculated. After that, optimal channel assignment, in other words, mapping table in terms of minimum or maximum cost is constructed. Okay, the first is let me explain how to predict the sensing result. As I said, in 5CSN, fusion center cannot specify the source of each sensing result because each sensor does not send any ID information to fusion center. But if we consider the extension to the time domain is like this, which means the fusion center keep collecting the sensing result for certain time duration. It's like this. So if the time continuity of sensing result is a peculiar feature for categorizing the sensing result into the group of sensor nodes. So therefore, data tracking, such as a Kalman filter, is available for detecting the sensing data. It's data tracking is like this. So we can obtain individual sensing data is obtained like this. So after that, we analyze the predicting probability of each sensing level. And these three data are sent by the sensor node, some specified sensor node, three data obtained. But the Kalman filter assumes the sensing data in next step is modeled by probability of Gaussian distribution. So therefore, we got mean value and deviations can be obtained. So from this result, estimated mean value is most powerful candidate for sensing result in next step. So therefore, if sensing result loss is occur, estimated mean value is considered as next sensing result. But in addition, from the Gaussian distributions, we can obtain occurrence probability of each sensing level can be obtained is like this. For example, sensing level 5 is in this area indicating the probability of fifth level sensing result. So therefore, we can obtain, we can predict the probability of each sensing level like this. After that, we also predicted the channel occupancy ratio by spectrum sensor and spectrum database. And we introduce spectrum sensor is like this. Spectrum sensor can detect the access from primary system. So spectrum sensor detects the channel access for certain time durations. It can calculate the average channel occupancy ratio in each channel. It's like this. This channel number 4 is almost 80% is occupied. It's like this. So COR is really helpful for estimating the how frequently the sensor of ICSN stops the sending the sensing result. So therefore, spectrum sensor periodically informs the COR and the location information of it to the spectrum database. So therefore, each COR with location information are informed to the spectrum database. In this situation, the fusion center is the role of the spectrum database. So finally, we got two predictions. First one is the probability of each sensing result, and second one is the channel occupancy ratio. If we consider PhiCSM, how to assign each channel? I mean, sensing level 5 is quite high probability, so which for sending this data, which channel should be selected? So therefore, we consider the how to construct a mapping table for minimizing or maximizing cost. So let me introduce two costs. First one is maximize the successful delivery rate, which is referred to as a Pmax. This is an optimization equation, is like this. Let me explain it. WKN is indicated the relation between the kth channel and nth sensing result. So WKN is 1 is the kth channel and nth sensing result. The relationship between kth channel and nth sensing result is constructed. And low KM is the COR of nth sensor and kth channel. And QMXN is the probability of nth sensing result in nth sensor node. So as we can see, 1 minus low KM means the availability of channel by secondary system. And QM is the probability is like this. So therefore, which means the expected successfully deliver to the sensing result is this equation. Therefore, if we maximizing that these equations, the successfully delivery rate is enlarged. So therefore, if we most largest probability of essential level should be assigned to the minimum COR, is this is one of the best results. Second one is a minimum mean square error case. Also, the optimization equation is like the model is like this. The difference between the MMSE and Pmax is this part. Mu m is mean value predicted by Kalman filter, and xn is an instantaneous sensing level. Before explaining it, we assume if sensor node stop sending sensing result to fusion center due to the primary system occupying the channel, FC can estimate the mean value from predicted sensing result as sending data. Therefore, the FC can calculate the expected error between the mean value of predicting sensing result and the true sensing data can be calculated, and like this. So MMSE criterion is a error should be minimizing as large as possible. So therefore, in this calculate here, I forgot to explain. This is a error is here, and this one and this one is a probability of error is occur. So error probability is occur. So therefore, in this equation, is expected error. So therefore, minimizing expected error. So MMSE situations. Okay. So it's okay. We introduced two optimization problems. First one is a Pmax, and second one is a MMSE. These two part maximum cost flow problem. MMSE is also minimum cost flow problem. These problems are famous for the operation research area. Actually, for recovering this problem, the number of combination pattern is a factorial of sensing level. It's quite NP hard problem. So for recovering this problem, we pay attention to the total unimodular matrix. Total unimodular matrix defined as follow. A total unimodular matrix is a matrix for which every square non-singular sum matrix is unimodular. Equivalently, every square sum matrix has the determinant 0 plus 1 or minus 1. This is one of the examples of mapping table. One indicates the relationship between the sensing level channel number is constructed. So we assume one by one relationship between the sensing level and channel number. So therefore, any column and any line is only one one. So as we can see, for example, if we consider this sum matrix, it's obviously rank of sum matrix is lower than full rank. So therefore, determinant is zero. And the other case in this sum matrix is here. This sum matrix is become identity matrix by switching the line. So therefore, determinant of identity matrix is one. Therefore, in any submatrix of selected, categorized to one. So therefore, this mapping table is obviously total unimodular. If solution matrix is composed of design variable has a totally unimodular property, the assignment problem can be solved even with the more standard simplex method by relaxing the binary constraint to the soft constraint. In other words, even if we assume Wij is real continuous value, the optimal result of it is given by integer. So in this situations, we can available Hungarian algorithm for a small and optimal solution. like this. The final is the computational complexity Hungarian algorithm is about n^3, so it's like quite low complexity for obtaining optimal solutions. And let me show the simulation result. Simulation parameter is like this. We assume the sensing result is modeled by random walk, like this. For evaluation, we consider three parameters. First one is the number of spectrum sensor. Spectrum sensor can estimate the COR in each location. As the number of sensors becomes larger, the accuracy of COR is improved. And the other one is a root mean square error for evaluating the accuracy of receiving sensing result. The definition is here. The final is the average successful delivery rate. Definition of SDR is the successful sending rate to total sending result ratio. These are simulation results. Left-hand side one is a vertical axis. A horizontal axis is the number of spectrum sensor. Is a vertical axis is average RMSE. Right hand side is a vertical axis is average SDR. FDMA means a packet access scheme. In this, in FDMA, each resource block or channel is assigned to individual sensor. So therefore, all the sensors simultaneously access to the fusion center. If the primary system occupies the channel, the each sensor node should be stopped. And the second one is a 5CSN. We use the PMAX, MMSC, and random assignment case. As we can see, average RMSE of 5CSN MMSC is best performances. And please see the SDR case. SDR case is 5CSN MMSC is slightly smaller than PMAX case. This is because compensation of predicting sensing result is available. So therefore, if the sensor node obtain mean value, it is not necessary for each sensor to send this value because fusion center has already known, has already predicted this value. So therefore, in this situation, sensor nodes could be stopped the sending data. So therefore, slightly SDR is slightly smaller. If we consider the usage efficiency of frequency spectrum, fewer SDR but a good RMSC accuracy result. So therefore, frequency spectrum usage efficiency is improved. Okay, let me conclude my presentation. I'd like to introduce 5CSM for supporting the real-time data gathering for sensing results. But if we, the disadvantage of 5CSM is unrecognizing the information ID of each sensing result and spectrum sharing. In this time, so for our work of spectrum sharing, for spectrum sharing, we use two predictions. First one is the sensing results, and second one is the channel occupancy ratio. For constructing the optimizations, so we use we pay attention to unimodular matrix. So there we got optimal assignment case. As assignment pattern, we can construct the assignment pattern. The final is in computer simulation, so we confirm the MMSC criterion is best performances and fewer SDR case. This is a reference. Thank you very much for your attention.